This ceremony is being presented and sponsored, co-sponsored by the Commissioners of St. Mary's County and the Leonardtown Commissioners. At this time, I'd like to introduce the George Washington Carver Elementary School Chorus under the direction of Miss Christina Baker.
Flag we fly, it's for Good evening, everyone. I'm Randy Guy, President of the Commissioners of St. Mary's County. Please join me in a round of applause for this chorus from George Washington Carver Elementary School's play. Under direction of Ms. Christina Baker, bringing to answer with a musical talent of patriotic selections. I invite you to stick around later on. The chorus from Leonardtown Elementary School will provide additional music entertainment for us after the end of this program. Okay, welcome everyone to the 29th Annual Flag Day Celebration sponsored by the Commissioners of St. Mary's County and the Leonardtown Commissioners. Flag Day recognizes the day in June of 1777 when the Continental Congress adopted the Stars and Stripes as the official flag of the United States. In a few moments, we will salute the American flag. But first, I'd like to introduce some of our stage guests. The Honorable Mike Hewitt. The Honorable Tom Jarbo. The Honorable Todd Morgan. The Honorable John E. O'Connor. Those are your commissioners for St. Mary's County, Maryland. Ms. Jamie Sterling is representing her father, the Honorable Governor Larry B. Hogan. The Honorable Deborah C. Ray, Maryland House of Delegates. The Honorable Matt Morgan, Maryland House of Delegates. The Honorable Roger L. Mattingly, Leonardtown Council Member. The Honorable Kathy Allen, Board of Education. Is she here? No, I'm sorry, not here. The Honorable Karen Bailey, at Board of Education. The Honorable Mary Washington, Board of Education. The Honorable Rita Weaver, Board of Education. Reverend Charles Gallagher, Our Lady of the Wayside Catholic Church. And Miss Diana Stelway, our vocalist. Is she right here? Go. Okay. Also, I want to recognize some of our special guests that's in the audience. Former Delegate Johnny Wood. I think he's in the back there. Captain Heidi Fleming, Commander Officer of the Naval Air Station Patuxent River. Dr. Rebecca Bridget, our County Administrator. I think I saw her come in. Okay. And Tom Mattingly, former County Commissioner President. Or I said County Commissioner. Please stand for the passing review and remain standing through the Star Spangled Banner. Members of Abate, please post the POW MIA flag. As we post the POW MIA flag for the ceremony, I am happy to announce that St. Mary's County government continues its pledge to remember all those who remain a prisoner of war or missing in action. Therefore, I am ordering that the POW MIA flag be flown at all county facilities and locations. This order is effective immediately. Reverend Gallagher from Our Lady of the Wayside Catholic Church, join us this evening to deliver the invocation.
Almighty God, we humbly thank you for this good land which you have given us for our inheritance. We pray that we may always prove to be a people mindful of your love and kindness. Bless this land with honest labor. Save us from violence, discord, and confusion, from pride and arrogance, and from every evil way. Preserve and increase our liberties, and fashion into one united nation this people of many races and tongues. Fill with the spirit of wisdom those to whom we entrust the authority of government, that they may seek justice and peace. In time of prosperity, fill our hearts with thankfulness, and in time of trouble, Do not allow our trust and hope in you to fail. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still
I will now read the proclamation on behalf of the Commissioners of St. Mary's County. Whereas Flag Day, June 14th, is a day for all Americans to celebrate and show respect for our flag, its designers and makers. Our flag is representative of our independence and our unity as a nation, one nation, under God, indivisible. And whereas Flag Day is a special day for our nation to reflect on our flag's special history and its meaning to Americans and people around the world. And whereas Flag Day, the anniversary of the official adoption of Stars and Stripes, was officially established by the proclamation of President Woodrow Wilson on May 30th, 1916. Flag Day was celebrated in various communities for years after Wilson's proclamation. And in 1949, President Truman signed an act of Congress designating June 14th of each year as National Flag Day. And whereas our flag of red, white, and blue symbolizes, per the 1977 Congress, 1777, white for purity and innocence, red for hardiness and valor, and blue for vigilance, preservation, and justice. Now, therefore, be it proclaimed that we, the Commissioners of St. Mary's County, do hereby declare Sunday, June 14, 2015, as National Flag Day in St. Mary's County, Maryland, and urge all citizens to take time to reflect upon the liberty and freedom we enjoy that our flag has come to represent and to display the flag proudly. Thank you. And I think next we're going to have the commissioner from Leonardtown Councilman Roger Mattingly.
Thank you, President Guy. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Leonardtown, the greatest small town in the world, right here, Leonardtown. Thank you. Thank you very much. For most Americans, National Flag Day is pretty self-explanatory. It may not have the exciting holiday history of Independence Day or the ceremonies of Memorial Day, but it maintains the highest, most distinctive level of any holiday. Seeing the stars and stripes flying outside of our homes and office building raises everyone's national pride. It is truly an honor and a privilege for me to be here this evening representing Leonardtown to present this proclamation to the good people of St. Mary's County and our nation, and to celebrate our nation's symbol of independence and unity, signifying our county's country's history and devotion to freedom, to the rule of all, and the equal rights of all. And now I'd like to read the proclamation. National Flag Day, June 14, 2015. I wasn't going to read this, but it's cooled off a little bit now, so I'm going to make you all sit here and suffer through my proclamation. Whereas an act of Congress of the United States dated June 14, 1777, the first official flag of the United States was adopted. And whereas the act of Congress dated August 3, 1949, June the 14th of each year was designated National Flag Day. And the Congress has requested the President to issue annually a proclamation designating this week in which June 14th occurs as National Flag Week. And whereas December 8, 1982, the National Flag Day Foundation Incorporated was chartered to conduct educational programs throughout the United States and promotion of National Flag Day, and to encourage national patriotism of all Americans by promotion of the pause for the Pledge of Allegiance as part of the National Flag Day ceremonies. Whereas National Flag Day celebrates our nation's symbol of independence and unity, signifying our country's history and devotion to freedom, to the rule of all, and equal rights of all. Now, therefore, we, the commissioners of Leonardtown, do hereby proclaim June 14th as National Flag Day in Leonardtown, in honor of our heritage, history, and our allegiance to the nation and our flag. Thank you very much.
Next, we have Ms. Jamie Sterling to read the citation from Governor Larry Hogan.
Good evening, everybody. I'm truly honored and proud to be here on behalf of my father, Governor Larry Hogan. I'm very proud to be here in Leonardtown in St. Mary's County, my home county, to deliver this proclamation from the governor's office. The State of Maryland Proclamation from the Governor of the State of Maryland, Flag Day, June 14, 2015. Whereas the American flag is a recognized symbol of freedom in the world today and continues to invoke feelings of patriotism, honor, and resolve among our nation's citizens and is a symbol of our democracy and freedom. And whereas Maryland, the great free state, is blessed with citizens who are extremely proud of our nation's mighty symbol of liberty, the United States flag. From the Revolutionary War to the writing of the Star Spangled Banner to this day, the configuration of the stars and stripes have changed, but its significance and symbolism have never wavered. And whereas the celebration of Flag Day is about history, about patriotism, about respect, and about community participation, this heralded celebration is first and foremost a day to promote pride in a land for which many brave men and women have defended and paid the ultimate sacrifice, and pride in an unparalleled system of democratic government. And whereas the people of Maryland are proud to observe Flag Day as a symbol of hope and inspiration to people at home and around the world, therefore, Lawrence J. Hogan, Jr., Governor of the State of Maryland, hereby proclaims June 14, 2015 as Flag Day in Maryland, and call upon the people of our state to join in supporting this observation observance. Given under the governor's hand and the great seal of the State of Maryland, this 14th day of June 2015, signed Lawrence J. Hogan, Jr.
I will now read a statement from U.S. Senator Barbara Mikulski. Dear President Guy and friends, thank you for the kind invitation to join your annual Flag Day celebration. I wish I could be there and all my friends from St. Mary's County and Southern Maryland for this uplifting event. I salute you for your patriotism and for your preparation and presentation of this inspiring program. On June 14, 1777, John Adams spoke about the flag at a meeting of the Continental Congress of Philadelphia. He stated the resolution of those assembled that the flag of the 13 United States shall be 13 stripes, alternate red and white, that the Union be 13 stars, white on blue field, representing a new constellation. Then in 1985, in Wabeka, Wisconsin, a 19-year-old teacher in a one-room school placed a 10-inch by 38 star flag in an inkwell and asked his students to write essays on what the flag meant to them. Stony Hill School is now a National Historic Site. June 14th is Flag Day, a national holiday, and young teacher Bernard J. Sigron became an American legend. The small slice of American history illustrates two great axioms. First, that one person can make a difference, and second, that patriotism must come from the heart, not as a result of an edict. Your love of country and respect for its traditions comes from the heart. You do not have to be reminded nor urged to pause for the Pledge of Allegiance. Thank you for all of you today and every day. God bless you, and may God continue to bless America. Barbara A. Mikulski. We'll now have Ms. Delegate Deb Bray for her presentation. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you for coming out to celebrate our flag and what it represents. When I was young, I heard comedian Red Skelton give the following speech about the Pledge of Allegiance, probably in a rerun since the original played on January 14, 1969 on the Red Skelton Show. And I was about 1 1/2. I didn't quite remember seeing it originally. Red's speech is as follows. When I was a small boy in Vincennes, Indiana, I heard, I think, one of the most outstanding speeches I ever heard in my life. I think it compares to the Sermon on the Mount, Lincoln's Gettysburg Address, and Socrates' speech to the students. We just finished reciting the Pledge of Allegiance, and he, Mr. Laswell, the principal of the high school, called us all together and he says, boys and girls, I've been listening to you recite the Pledge of Allegiance all semester, and it seems that it has become monotonous to you. Or could it be you do not understand the meaning of each word? If I may, I would like to recite the pledge and give you a definition for each word. I. Me, an individual, a committee of one. Pledge, dedicate all my worldly good to give without self-pity. Allegiance, my love and my devotion. To the flag, our standard, Old Glory, a symbol of courage, and wherever she waves, there's respect. Because your loyalty has given her a dignity that shouts, freedom is everybody's job. Of the United States, that means we have all come together. States, individual communities that have united into 48 great states, 48 individual communities with pride and dignity and purpose, all divided by imaginary boundaries, yet united to a common cause, and that's love of country, of America, and to the republic, a sovereign state in which power is invested into the representatives chosen by the people to govern, and the government is the people, and it's from the people to the leaders, not from the leaders to the people, for which it stands. One nation, meaning so blessed by God, indivisible, incapable of being divided, with liberty, which is freedom, the right of power of one to live his own life without fears, threats, or any sort of retaliation. And justice, the principle and qualities of dealing fairly with others. For all. For all. That means, boys and girls, it is as much your country as it is mine. Since I was a small boy, two states have been added to our country, and two words have been added to the Pledge of Allegiance, under God. Wouldn't it be a pity if someone said, that is a prayer, and that it be eliminated from our schools too? Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for letting me share this with you. I ask you keep this in mind as we stand to say the Pledge of Allegiance. Thank you.
Now we have Delegate Morgan, who's going to give his speech and presentation. Thank you.
Well, just a mic a little higher here. Thank you all for coming out here today. I mean, you braved the heat. Now you're getting ready to brave a thunderstorm here. So it's good to be with so many patriots that believe the same thing that I believe. Since 1777, when the first Congress adopted this flag, it stood for freedom. United we stand. And that's what I believe in. And I'm proud to be an American. I'm proud to represent you all. So thank you so much. Please be safe out here in a few minutes. Thank you.
Thank you, Matt. Thank you, Delegate Morgan. At this time, I'd like to introduce the Leonardtown Elementary School Chorus under the direction of Miss Nicole, Miss Beard, who will entertain us with a few patriotic tunes.
Mother's love has gathered.
We're getting close to closing up here. We're getting a little cloudy. So at this time, I want to call up Reverend Gallagher again to deliver a benediction.
Let us pray. O Lord, the whole world is full of your glory. We commend our country to your merciful care, that we may follow your guidance and live in peace. Give to the President of these United States, our Governor, our Commissioners, our delegates, and to all authority, wisdom and strength to know and to do your will. Fill them with the love of truth, honesty, and righteousness. Make them always remember that they are your servants, called to lead and serve this nation and state in the fear of your righteous judgments. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and governs with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you, Father. It's very good. Okay, in conclusion, ladies and gentlemen, this concludes our formal Flag Day ceremony. I want to express our sincere gratitude for the men and women of the Leonardtown Volunteer Fire Department, Bay District Volunteer Fire Department, for bringing their ladder trucks and raising our flag. And thanks to the Disabled American Veterans and Disabled American Veterans Auxiliary, St. Mary's Unit 26, for the participation. Thank you to the 7th District Optimist Club for providing our refreshments. So remember to raise the flag today and every day with pride. I also like to remind you that there's proper disposal of our flag when it's been torn, tattered, and no longer serviceable. Thank you for joining us this evening, and we'll see you again next year.